While the battery in the iPhone 4 is a big improvement over its predecessors, over time its capacity will diminish, and you'll feel the pressure to buy a whole new phone just because it doesn't hold a charge the way it used to. Here's the big secret. You can replace the battery yourself. It only takes like 10 minutes, and it costs way less than buying a whole new phone. Hi, I'm MJ with iFixit.com, and today I'm going to show you how to replace the battery in your iPhone 4. While this is probably one of the easier repairs you'll ever do, you'll still want to follow the step-by-step instructions and the repair guide on our site. Tool-wise, this repair couldn't get much easier. All you're going to need is a Phillips 00 screwdriver, which I got from our 26-piece bit driver kit, a set of plastic opening tools, and a replacement battery. Now, there's a chance that Apple didn't use Phillips screws in your iPhone. Apple has also been using a new 5-pointed tamper-resistant screw, and if your phone has those, you'll want to check out our iPhone 4 Liberation Kit that comes with the driver you will need to get those screws out. Before we get started, we're going to make sure that the silent switch is activated and the phone is powered off. That's the only real trick to the repair. I'm going to go ahead and remove these two Phillips 00 screws from down by the dock connector. And once those screws are removed, the rear panel should just slide up like a couple of millimeters and it pulls right off. Really easy, right? There's one screw that I'm going to have to remove before I can get to the battery. So I'll go ahead and take that out. And after that screw is removed, I'm going to use one of my plastic opening tools, stay, to lift up the connection on this battery connector. I'm only going to pry it from the top and the bottom, paying careful attention not to pry on the pressure contact itself. And once that's lifted off, I can take this antenna contact out and set it aside. Now, you could use this little plastic pull tab to remove the battery, but I've heard that on some iPhones, Apple used a lot of adhesive, and so when you go to pull the pull tab, you pull it right off, which isn't good. If you're struggling with it, just use one of your plastic opening tools and kind of pry up around the edge of the battery. I'm going to try the pull tab, and it comes right out. So I'll put my old battery aside and put my new battery in. And before I reassemble the phone, I'm going to make sure to clean off all the metal-to-metal contacts with some kind of degreaser like Windex, because the oils on your fingers can cause wireless interference in your phone. And when you have AT&T as a carrier, you can't really afford that. Just kidding. Not really. After I've cleaned off my contact points, I can reassemble my iPhone and get back to playing Angry Birds without killing my battery. Of course, you can find all the parts and tools for this and many other repairs at iFixit.com. And if you run into problems during your repairs, there are lots of resources in the iPhone repair manual section of our site. Thanks for watching and happy repairing.